starts swaying to and fro. I have never heard that song before, but if I don't hear it anymore, it's still familiar to me, sends a thrill right through me, 'cause those chords remind me of the night that I first fell in love to those magic changes.
Alan, Kat, thank you very much for joining me today. So the first question that I'm going to ask is Alan. So what is the idea of the music video?
The idea of the music video? Well, okay, let's clear the story up. Okay, so it's about a mechanic and his love interest. And they just finished school, but that's not so important. And essentially at prom night, things get a little bit frisky.
I just wanted to see their reaction.
Anyway, and so Linda, which is the name of the girl, she finds out she's pregnant with his baby.
Shock horror.
And she runs off in a little bit of a, oh Johnny, gee whiz, I did a bad. And
she's a bit of a state, basically. She's kind of confused and upset, so she abandons Bean, the male actor,
and goes off somewhere to raise the child, but then she realises that she can't do it on her own, so she comes back into his loving arms,
and they raise a family.
Yeah. Yeah, there you go.
So, the next question I want to ask is, what was the first couple of days filming actually like?
I'll take this one. Okay. So the first day I feel it was nightmarish because I am not a trained camera operator, so I had no idea what I was doing. I was constantly changing cameras because I was confused and upset. I was like crying. It was a nightmare. Our actors were nervous. The second day was okay. But the first day, it was an absolute nightmare.
I think it
was,
as well.
It was a nightmare.
Okay, like, let's just say the first day was... was the training wheels on our bike ride to glory?
You like that? We're taking this very seriously, aren't we?
Okay, no, we are. We are professional directors and camera operators. Anyway.
I'm a waitress.
I'm trying this. But the first day was a bit, okay, kids, let's just say this was a rough day, and when I went home, I just went home and drank all the wine.
You didn't drink anything! Shut up! You're lying! You're lying to the camera. You're lying to the camera and you're lying to me.
And what did you know what I did at 7 p.m. at night? I got home later than you.
Good for you.
So at the end of the day, it was quite challenging then?
Yeah, there was challenges.
It was very hard to kind of get to grips with everything.
I think it was more because of the fact that the darkroom scene, Natalie and Lee just met each other. We were kind of starting to set into the mindset. So it was a lot of jumbled pieces.
For being honest, we should have probably filmed it a couple of days after they met each other because they were...
They didn't
know each other. So they were finding it hard to interact and be like comfortable with each other.
Yeah,
which is natural if you're an actor and an actress.
We're sorry, Natalie and Lee.
And did that also make it hard for the actors to actually act professionally?
Oh no, they were good as gold.
They were really sweet, they were really, really smart, and they knew what they were doing. But we just, I feel like sometimes they need a little bit of guidance, which is okay, because it wasn't...
We're there for each other.
I think when I explained the concept to Leah, I wasn't very clear about it.
No, I did have a very, very long sort of walkthrough of the whole thing at some point. The actors, though, I can't say bad things about them because one's my sister, so I'd get killed. Mm-hmm. That is true. But yeah, I mean, Lee was a good actor, Natalie was a good actor, and I think it's literally the reason why we had to reshoot is just not because of their acting, it was more of us, but it would have helped if they weren't feeling so awkward, which is natural.
You can be uncomfortable with obviously people you don't know, and especially if it's not a very common thing for you to do when acting.
True.
They're not acting pleasing model, and does linguistics.
She does social science.
Is it linguistics?
Yeah, linguistics. A word I can't say.
Linguistics.
Linguini, I'll go with that.
Okay, another question which I want to ask is, like, is you're the director and you're the camera, and you're the camera operator, so...
I am the camera.
Embody that camera. We're a bit weird, sorry.
So, what was the most challenging part for each of your job roles throughout the production and also the pre-production as well?
Trying not to make the actors laugh, I'm a stupid comment behind
it was really hard to keep everything afloat because we had a lot of problems when shooting where the camera would ever break down, because it would go out of charge, or use something. So my main issue was like filming cohesively and trying to make it look seamless without
obviously degrading energy. Where am I going with that? Quality.
I know what you mean. Yeah. Well, we shot with at least different. Was it about five different cameras? We shot with five different cameras.
So
two iPhones, three main cameras. It was ridiculous, and I would not recommend shooting with one.
That was the original shots. We're going to reshoot those. Well, we did reshoot them.
Yeah. At this point.
I think the hardest bit for me was generally just getting my ideas across. Because sometimes, obviously, your ideas aren't the best the first time around. They're never the best the first time around.
Which is fair.
Trying to originally get your ideas across, especially when, for me, I'm a very reclusive, shy guy, I would say.
Yeah.
And I guess it was hard to explain my ideas at first, so it did lead to some communicative problems.
Yeah.
So I think the hardest bit for me was kind of, because I did a lot of the work beforehand, before filming, so I kind of didn't really see very hard things except for talking to a lot of people.
Was it hard to find the locations for the music video, or was it fairly easy?
Well, we had a lot of...
This is your thing, because I did nothing about the locations.
Yeah. Well, it wasn't... One thing about my locations is that I've had to keep most of them a secret, which is a bit... It was a bit strange for my group, but... Essentially, it was the case of, I have a lot of family friends who are already in the mechanic motor sort of industry anyway, so it was kind of easy to ask if I could use their garage. And, I mean, we used public spaces like the footpaths, so you didn't really need permission to search. I mean, there was meant to be a location in Ongar with the train station, but they didn't really give us permission to film, sadly, so it is what it is.
Was there any issues with the actors and also the production team?
One of the defence fighters, so that wasn't great for anyone involved.
Right. I hope you get better soon.
He's not watching that.
I don't mind.
Okay. Our actors were like, we had a couple drop out, which is naturally going to happen.
Yeah.
We have teenagers and professional actors. But luckily, I kind of spirit of the moment, I asked my mate Lee, who was good as gold, no issues, really sweet guy, and was more than happy to come help us out.
I forced my sister.
Yeah, your sister Nat was great. She was great. She did really well.
She's a little sweetheart.
She was very bright for the role. It was really interesting to like watch her kind of adapt, and like she got very comfortable very quickly. In the process of 3 days.
I think it's because they, like, even though they were strangers at the beginning, they became friends.
That's such a sweet amazing thing. Good job, everybody.
We should be friendship, like, after this, we should make an agency for friendship matching.
Oh. Was there any issues with the production team as well?
I don't want to say anything. This is like flying out the pan. There wasn't
no
any...
Comment.
There wasn't any problems
cuts
in
out.
The sense of, it was more about getting everything set
yeah.
up at the right time. and deadlines being met in the sense of, well, we had a lot of pre-production work that was kind of behind schedule, but we did finish it in the deadline. It was just pretty much it, yeah.
Was there any issues with the filming in the locations, or was it all fairly easy?
Only obstruction we really had from people walking in the public path in Tokyo, but that was about it really. We didn't really have...
And weather.
The weather was only a slight issue because it rained on the first day of filming. We were going to go back to Wanra and film some scenes, but
yes.
We couldn't because of the rain, obviously. So that was inconvenient to everyone involved. Who does?
No one likes the rain. Wait, the rain. But, anywho, so there wasn't really location-wise problems, were there?
Not really. It could have been problems, but it wasn't. It was pretty much smooth sailing with the location.
I remember one problem.
Oh.
It got way too hot in here.
Yeah. We were all very frustrated. It was a nightmare.
I was ready to sleep.
I was ready to, freak out and cry a bit.
And also, what do you think of the overall outcome of the music video as all of the filming has been done? What do you think of the outcome overall?
I
could have done better. I, personally, as a camera approach, I'm not speaking for anybody else in the group, I could have taken the shots and been more cohesive, but I didn't. And it's okay not to be good at stuff. You kind of have to understand that sometimes you're not going to be amazing at everything.
This was the first
time I'd taken kind of the reins.
They've done really well for their first time.
And my talent is in words. And I can really do that in this project. So, it's okay. I'm not even trying to make a sub story. It's more of I think it's really important to understand that you can't get everything right all the time. If something does go wrong, you're able to own up to it and talk about why it may have not gone right. I didn't do everything right because I wasn't prepared. I didn't take enough workshops with Dave. I didn't really immerse myself in the project as much as I could have. But that's fine. It's okay not to be good at stuff.
I mean, this was my first time being a director, and I really like making stories and all the creative aspect.
You did really good.
But I'm never doing a music video again. This is the one production that you'll ever see in your lives by me, unless it's book. That's the only production that you'll see. I've learned that making a music video is more work than it is. You're gonna think it's all hunky-dory, and bam, it smacks you in the face at 3 a.m. when you're right to a strip sale.
It's hunky-dory, but it's more like the rise of